All right. Let's see how we're sounding today. Let's try that special number we've been working on. Ready? One, two, ready, and.
Blessing, glory, sing hallelujah.
I don't understand it. My pastor always told me that once I got to heaven, I would be able to make a joyful noise.
Just give it a little more time. Okay, everybody, let's try it one more time. Ready?
Hey, Angel!
Hey, you guys! Hey, how's it coming?
Not too well. We just can't seem to get it.
Hey, I know what you guys need.
What?
Some music.
Hey, how'd you do that?
What'd you expect? This is heaven.
Throne of crystal light. Dwells the God.
Well, Leisha, is he great or what?
Oh, Angel, you were right. I mean, heaven is great and all, but he's really...
Awesome?
Yeah, awesome.
Well, let's get on with our tour then. There is so much more to see, so many more people I want you to meet. In fact, just a minute ago, I saw
Angel.
Right... Yeah? What is it?
I'm really excited about heaven and all. It's just that I'm a little confused. Why am I here?
Well, Leisha, when you were 8 years old, you and your mother knelt down by your bed and...
No. I mean, why am I here now?
Oh, that. That's a good question.
Well?
Well, I have no idea. But isn't this exciting? Now, Leisha, look, right over here. I want you to
Wait. I need to know why I'm here. I mean, I'm only 17. Or, I was 17. However that works. Anyway, why now? There was so much more to do on Earth. Philip and Callie were just starting to come to our youth group. Our mission trip was only 2 weeks away. And my friendship with Kevin... Angel, why now?
I told you. I don't know. But isn't this exciting?
You keep saying that. Isn't what exciting?
Providence.
Providence? What's providence?
Providence? Providence is that unique and oftentimes mysterious way in which the Heavenly Father works everything out to accomplish His will. It's a hard term to define.
What do you mean?
Okay, look. It's more something you see. Well, it's not exactly something you see. It's more something you look back on. Yeah. Yeah, that's it. You look back on it. Sometimes things happen that don't make any sense right then. But in time, we look back and they make perfect sense. It's when we look back that we realize the Heavenly Father was involved every step of the way. That's the big picture. That's providence. Leisha, I don't know why you're here now, but the Father doesn't do anything without a good reason. That's why I'm so excited.
We could never make it on our own. That was quite a funeral. I didn't know there were that many flowers.
The music was so beautiful. I can sure understand why Mrs. Johnson had trouble getting through her solo. She was brave to even try.
I've never seen that many people in a church before. The place was packed.
And hot, too.
This may be the wrong time to ask, but does anybody know what actually happened?
I talked to Kevin last night, and he said he doesn't remember a thing.
The policeman told my parents that it was just one of those freak accidents where both drivers were just too close to the center line.
I can believe it. That curve is so sharp, there's no way to tell if a car is coming from the other direction.
What happened to the guy in the truck?
Apparently, he wasn't hurt at all. Just Leisha and Kevin.
Oh, yeah. I told Kevin a bunch of us might visit him Saturday night. I'm going around 8 o'clock, if anybody wants a ride.
I heard somebody say that Kevin won't be able to play football again. Is that true?
Well, if it is, then his dad will probably... Well, football was real important to his dad. He always wanted to play but couldn't. So he really pushed Kevin.
Pushed isn't the word. It's more like threatened.
Yeah, he was really hard on him. But then when you think about the scholarship offers that keep rolling in, well, I guess all that's kind of meaningless now.
This whole thing is meaningless.
Hey, I know this is a dumb question, but why do you think God let this happen?
I don't think that's such a dumb question. I keep asking myself the same thing. I know we're not supposed to be talking
about... Well, I think it stinks. It doesn't make any sense at all. I mean, of all people, why Leisha? Why anybody, for that matter? But why did it have to be Leisha?
Yeah, I know what you mean. No matter who it was, it would be bad. But somebody like Leisha, I don't understand. She was like the best person I ever met. You know what I mean. There was just something different about her. She was so...
Consistent.
Yeah. All of us have tried to be religious from time to time. But Leisha, she was consistent. It was all so real to her.
Well, at least we know one thing for sure. We do know where Leisha is.
Seems like it was only yesterday.
She was living here.
Peaceful, I hear Leisha singing in heaven.
Honey, how can you pray? I mean, how can you continue to have faith in a God who allows something like this to happen to our son? Think about it. If he's the loving God you've been telling me he is, he wouldn't have wanted something like this to happen. And if he is all-powerful, he could have kept this from happening. So why didn't he? I'm sorry. It's just that I don't want you to be disillusioned.
I'm not disillusioned. And Al, there was a time when you wouldn't have been disillusioned either. We don't always know why God allows things to happen.
Well, that makes me feel a lot better. You realize what's going to happen, don't you?
What do you mean?
Kevin was driving. That makes us responsible. Liable.
What?
Leisha's parents could sue us for everything we own.
Honey, it was an accident. The police said it was an accident. And besides, the Walkers are fine Christian people, and they've been wonderful neighbors for a long time. They wouldn't think of such a thing.
Sure. When this thing starts to sink in, you can bet they're going to be looking for somebody to blame.
Al, Leisha thought of us like second parents. And the Walkers, honey, they love you. I just...
No, they love you. They've never really accepted me. I'm different from them, and when reality sets in, you may find that they're different as well. Maybe you better pray after all.
The beat of different drums.
Why would Mr. Baker think my dad would sue him? That's ridiculous. My parents love the Bakers. I mean, we live next door and all. And what did Mrs. Baker mean when she said there was a time when Mr. Baker wouldn't have been so disillusioned? I thought he's always been kind of, you know, leery of anything that had to do with God or church.
No. No, when Kevin's parents were first married, Mr. Baker had a strong relationship with the Heavenly Father. As time passed, however, he began to drift. He got caught up in his work, and he began to care more about what his friends thought than what God thought. Eventually, he stopped going to church, and by the time Kevin was old enough to remember, there wasn't much evidence of any spiritual life at all. You know, I think something's happening here. Yeah, I've seen this before. It's providence.
Providence. There's that word again.
You see, Leisha, the Father always has the end in sight. He's constantly working to bring about his purpose and objectives. Everything, and I do mean everything, is working together to ensure that this takes place. Granted, his purposes are often a mystery, and most of the time they remain a mystery right up to the very end. There was only one time when we thought the Father had lost control. When we got the news he had sent his son into your world, we were worried. When we heard he had taken on human form, we were really worried. No offense. We watched in horror as he was continuously mistreated. It didn't make any sense. Why would the Father allow this to happen to his son? We kept wondering, why doesn't he reveal his glory? Why doesn't he unleash his power? Himself to be crucified by the very ones he had come to save. We waited for a signal. Just a glance from the Father would have sent 10,000 of us to his rescue. But the signal never came, and Jesus died. But don't you see? We didn't understand. We didn't have the big picture. We just didn't know. Nobody knew until the whole thing was over.
Nobody knew.
Yeah.
So you see, the greatest tragedy in history became the greatest victory in history. Now you see why I'm so excited.
I think I'm beginning to understand.
I think we're in the room. I don't know where we are.
Shh! Be quiet, everybody.
Yeah, Greg, this is a hospital, not the zoo. If that head nurse finds us, we're history.
Okay, here's his room. Now remember, you guys, light. Keep it light.
K-Man!
Hey! What are you guys doing here? Visiting hours ended 30 minutes ago.
Hey, Mr. Baker.
Wow, what a surprise. How did you guys manage to slip by the Gestapo out there?
It was easy. Tammy sweet-talked the security guard, and I charmed the babes at the nurse's station.
I'll just let you guys talk.
Hey, Kevin, we brought you a few things. We have milkshakes, compliments of Burger Hut. We have tunes, compliments of Tim's brother. We have pizza, compliments of Chan's House of Pizza and Sushi. And we've got Algebra 2, compliments of Coach Jones.
You're all heart.
And we have flowers, compliments of my neighbor, Mrs. Whitaker.
Mrs. Whitaker? I don't even know a Mrs. Whitaker.
That's okay. She doesn't even know we have our flowers.
Kevin, how do you feel?
Actually, I'm doing pretty good.
Well, we sure do miss you.
Yeah, I'm missing you guys too.
Kevin, is it true that you won't be able to play football anymore?
Jill!
Oh, now that's light.
Well, that's all right. Yeah, Jill, as far as football is concerned, it's over.
You don't seem very upset about it.
Are you kidding? When I first found out, I was destroyed. But since then, something on the inside of me has changed. Somehow I believe that God is a part of all this. It's like he's doing something and I'm just one small part of this big picture.
God? Kevin, what about football? What about your dreams? How can you just turn your back on all that? I thought that's what you lived for.
Scott, I haven't forgotten all of that. Believe me, I've given it a ton of thought. And I haven't abandoned my dreams. It's just that, well, you might say I've had to make a dream adjustment. Yeah, a dream adjustment.
Hello, everybody. Look, if I'm interrupting anything, I can come back later.
No, no problem. We were just leaving. Bye, Kevin.
Later, Kevin.
Hey, don't forget your homework.
Yeah, see you around.
Hey, Al, Kevin, it looks like you're getting plenty of company. I won't stay long, I promise. I just came from my attorney's office and had some things for the two of you to look over. Let's see.
Well, you could have at least called first. Besides, I really don't think it's appropriate to discuss this in front of Kevin.
Wait a minute, Dad. It's not
Hold on, son. Let me handle this. Look, Al, Kevin's been through a lot, and besides, it really wasn't his fault.
Here they are. I guess maybe I should have called first, but I knew Kevin would want to see this.
Well, you'll be hearing from my attorney in the morning.
Oh, there's no need. My attorney handled the whole thing. The fund was instated as of 4:30 this afternoon, and Kevin's scholarship is on record. All of the two of you need to do is sign on the dotted line.
Hereby awards the first scholarship to Kevin M. Baker. The scholarship? They gave you a scholarship.
Yes, Dad. That's what I was trying to tell you.
Al, I don't know what to say.
Listen, I think I'd better run. Kevin, I'll try to come by tomorrow when I can stay longer. Al, if you need anything, Jackie and I will be at home all week. Please call. Bye.
Bye, Mr. Walker.
Bye.
I'm sorry, Dad. I should have told you. I wanted to wait until I could tell you and Mom together, but I guess that...
They gave you a scholarship?
Yeah, pretty cool, huh?
Oh, yeah, that's pretty cool. Hey, I better get back home. You know how your mom is about being alone, and I'll swing back by tomorrow after work.
Okay. Besides, it looks like I've got plenty to keep me busy.
Son, I overheard you talking to your friends about rearranging your dreams. Do you really believe that?
Yes, sir. I really do.
Kevin, I want you to know that, well, I really better go.
Bye, Dad.
I knew my dad was great, but I mean, this is really unbelievable. And poor Mr. Baker. If only he could see what I see. He still doesn't have a clue, does he?
Well, I don't know about that. I think he was just handed a major clue, and from the look on his face, I think he knows just where to go for the next one.
All things work for a good, though sometimes we can't see how they could. Struggles that break our hearts in two sometimes blind us to the truth.
And we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. What then shall we say in response to this? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also, along with him, graciously give us all things? Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble or hardship or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword? No. In all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us.
For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord.
I tell you?
Providence? Providence! I think I'm finally beginning to see the big picture. God is working through the good and the bad. Even when it doesn't make sense, he's there. He's always there. Providence really is something you look back on. Wow!
Well then, why don't we finish your tour? Now let's see, if you look right back over there, you'll see
But wait! What about Kevin? What's gonna happen to Kevin?
Leisha, I have no idea, but isn't it exciting?